of my children in this church will be what will be left here of John Saylor. But there's a leader that we all should follow. Somebody help me this morning. That his name is Jesus Christ. Amen. And he thought it was important to give us a word in Matthew chapter 3. He thought it, he inspired it by the Holy Ghost written of men of old, that we should know this. Amen. Now, I don't know where everybody has come from in their life. We learned a lot about Brother Darren today. But there's probably more that we don't even know. Amen, somebody. But there's things in each and every one of our lives that God is just trying to say, why don't you just let go of it? Why don't you just let it out? Why don't you just go ahead and trust God to see if he can't take what we call life, or what I call about myself, a mess. And let me just take those broken pieces, let me put them back together, and let me give you some honor in your life. That God in heaven will be honored, amen. Not that it's going to do anything else for anybody else, but that it's going to bring honor and glory to the one that deserves all honor and all glory. Somebody say amen. 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 We find in these verses, and I picked this today because here in a little bit, we're going to go down to the lake. And we're going to, some of us are going to get baptized. Huh? Listen here, Karen. I want you to tell you right now, I'm going to follow the title of my sermon. Let me pop that back to the title. Follow the leader. Ain't nobody in this church getting baptized before I get baptized. Amen, somebody. I want you to know that in this church, we don't just preach at you. We practice what we preach. Amen. If you see me uptown, you're going to see me just like I am now. When I see you downtown, or I see you on the ground, I'm going to stop by like the Good Samaritan, and I'm going to try to help you get back up. And all I have to offer, I'm just like Peter and John when they went up to pray. I don't have silver and gold, but such as I have, and his name is Jesus Christ, rise up off the ground and get up and walk again. Get up and live again. And I'm telling you right now that when it comes down from the Father on high and it blesses me and it comes to you, God is going to get the glory from Redemption Church of All Blair. And I'm saying that, proclaiming it over each and every one of your life. I've come to tell you, you need to be saved, you need to repent, and you need to be baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost, the power of God from on high. Why somebody praise God today? I'm grateful for it today. Just something about when you start talking about that wonderful name of Jesus, that stuff starts to break, and stuff starts to go, and stuff starts to come off of you, and all you want to do is start raising your hands and clapping your hands and hollering to the highest mountain that Jesus Christ is coming soon, and he is the God, the one that every knee that will bow and every tongue will confess Jesus Christ is Lord. While somebody praise him this morning. Amen. I got a little excited and I'm trying not to.
It's all good.
That's the wrong one. Here we go. I normally have this ready. It's on the screen. Verse number 11, this is John the Baptist talking to the people that were lined up that day to get baptized.
Amen.
Somebody say, I'm getting baptized today. Come on now, I think we need to get some more people baptized today, amen. There's more that should have been here this morning. That's okay. We'll break ice to baptize somebody. We'll stand on top of the ice and dunk you and bring you back out, amen. Amen. But there's some people that are going to get baptized today. They're going to stand in front of all the world and say, I'm buried with Jesus Christ, and now I'm resurrected into new life, and this body may die, but that soul's going to live forever, and I'm going to be with Jesus. I will not relent. I will not turn around. I've made up my mind that I'm going to heaven, and there ain't no devil in hell that can stop me. I've made up my mind that Jesus is the way. He is the want you to give you some praise this morning.
Amen.
John said, I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. But he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I'm not worthy to carry or to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost. Somebody say, I want to be baptized in the Holy Ghost. Amen. I want a new life in me. I want something that I can't describe. I want to tell somebody it's better felt than told. I want the Holy Ghost. And God said it's his good pleasure to give you those gifts. Somebody say, I need the Holy Ghost in here this morning. And I need it with fire. I need to be purged now. I need the old things that Darren talked about to be gone from me forever. I don't ever want to hear that about me. I want the Holy Ghost in fire. And I want to know beyond any shadow of a doubt, when Jesus calls my name, I'm going to be with him forever. And there ain't nobody can stop me from being where God called me to be. Well, somebody praise God this morning. I got a bad case of I can't help it this morning. Because I know there's some people that have made it up in their mind that we used to be this, but we ain't this no more. We got a new name written down in glory, and it's mine and it's all mine. And one of these days when the roll is called up yonder, I'm going to be with my name that's written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Those rust and wall that's and thieves can't get to them. I'm going to love you in heaven, and the journey gets awful sweet. Somebody praise God for me this morning. His hand. You know, when you start a fire, you got to have some air. When God starts to burn things off, you got to know that you're going to fire it up real good, and he's going to get it hot enough that the old stuff starts to fall off. His hand is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge your life, the floor of your life, the bottom place of your life. Ain't your place no more. You got a new place. We'll be right back. Somebody say it like you mean it now. Say, God, Jesus, say, I don't know where you were. I don't know what you was doing. But thank God Jesus came into my life. Thank God that he came into my life and he made me more than a conqueror. Through him and in my strength, he is in my weakness, he is made strong. Thank God for Jesus. Somebody say, thank God for Jesus. You see, Jesus ain't gonna tell you to do nothing. At every point that you've been tried, everything you've been tempted with there, he was tempted right there too. But the difference between him and me and you, he didn't fail. But you know what? He said, they can't make it back to God unless I give my love for you. And I don't care what anybody else tells you there, he gave his life for you. He didn't take it from you. They didn't kill it. He laid it down. He gave his life for you.
Come on.
while you have a chance, get yourself in the water and get yourself baptized. Get your name on the church roll. Get your name on the heavenly roll. And give God praise for all he's done for you. That's what this day is for. Testimony would be changed at that point, but it's not too late. You can use that testimony from this day forward. There are things back there that you can change. There are some things that are forever the same, and they won't be changed. All you can do is repent and ask God to forgive you and walk forward, testify of the goodness of Jesus Christ. When I should have been good, should have been my praise. God has mercy. God has grace. Or to be so now. Quit waiting. What are we waiting for?
That's right.
What do we got to see next? God gave us a place to have an assembly.
Yes.
God has healed people. God has saved people. What in the world are you waiting for? Jesus is calling today.
Amen.
Make your path straight. John the Baptist called them vipers. I'm not going to call you that. I'm just going to tell you this. Make your path straight. Get into the water. Tell the world that I love Jesus Christ, and I'm buried in his death, and I'm resurrected in new life. If you won't remember me from this day forward, I'll come forward and I'm going to change by the grace of God. While somebody prays for them. We got the talking part done, John. Baptize me. Don't tell me what you want me to do. When you were in your mother's belly, we'd you jump for joy at the sound that I was coming to this earth. Don't sit here and argue with me. Get baptized. Somebody look at me and say, I'm getting baptized today. Don't stand here and say, hey, you do this next week. That's what you may be snowing. It's Michigan right now. Let me tell you right now, you need to get baptized, and you need to do it now. Somebody say, I need to do it now, because you don't know what's going to be tomorrow. This morning I got up and I looked out the window. You know it was raining. I said, that ain't gonna stop what we're gonna do. We're gonna get wet anyhow. We're gonna baptize. Unless there's lightning, we're gonna get baptized. I'm not scared. We're gonna get baptized. Sins washing off of us. We're gonna be made white as snow, white as snow. The old things that we used to do, we're gonna stop doing. The old way we used to talk, we're gonna stop talking that way. The old places we used to go, we ain't going there no more. Because we're getting brand new. We're getting washed today. We're gonna get clean today. And let me tell you something right now. If Jesus thought it was important for him to be baptized, I would just go ahead and wager to say he makes it important for you to get baptized. Somebody agree with a great big amen on that. The blessing to come across to fulfill all righteousness. I want to live right. I want to live right. I don't like looking over my shoulder. I don't like thinking about the things that are behind me. I want to live right.
Amen.
Then he suffered him. You know what he did? All right, you got a deal. You want to be baptized? Get in this water. And get yourself down here now, and I'm going to baptize you. Let's see what happens. And Jesus, when he was baptized, he went up straightway out of the water, and lo, the heavens opened up unto him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting on him. Come on, turn me. Him I am well pleased. If you want to make heaven happy today, get yourself in the water and let the pastors come out of you.
Yeah.